الحمد للإله سابغ النعم وخالق الإنسان من بعد العدم، فالحمد ثم الحمد ثم الحمد لك حمدا كثيرا طيبا يا رب لك. أعطيتنا خيرا كثيرا ربنا، سترت عن كل الورى عيوبنا، ثم الصلاة بعد والتسليم على النبي المصطفى الكريم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، we were still discussing the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that relate to the concept of rahma or rahima. And one of the most famous lexicons of the Arabic language by Imam al-Raghib al-Asfahani, and one of the first dictionaries ever written, he defines rahima in a very interesting manner. He says rahima is the verb that is used to indicate ihsan, to indicate doing good for the sake of wanting to do good to the one you're doing good to, without expecting anything back from that person. So rahima means to want to benefit somebody, genuinely help somebody, and you don't require anything back from that person. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned in the last 2 days, has ascribed this concept to himself in over 500 verses. And he has at least 5 names that we know of related to this concept of rahmah. And the term ar-Rahman, or the name ar-Rahman, it occurs in the Quran 57 times. And it is never paired with any other name except in 6 verses. And it is only paired in this 6 verses with one name, and that is ar-Rahim. The term ar-Rahman always occurs by itself, 51. But in 6 verses, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim occur. And of course, in the Fatiha is the first example, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And I mentioned one opinion about the difference between Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, and that is that Ar-Rahman is for all the creation, and Ar-Rahim is for the believers. There is another interpretation, and these are all complementary, that Ar-Rahman is the one whose rahmah is comprehensive, ذو رحمة الواسعة. And Ar-Rahim is the one whose rahmah reaches the one he wants to reach. The rahmat al-wasila. So Ar-Rahman is comprehensive. And Ar-Rahim is the one that is effective to the one whom it reaches. And Allah is both comprehensive and effective. Allah is both Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. Yet another interpretation is that Allah is Ar-Rahman in this world and Ar-Rahim in the next world. That this world is a manifestation of Allah's rahmah, and the next world, the Jannah for the believers, is a manifestation that Allah Azza wa Jal is Ar-Rahim. Yet another interpretation, and these are all complementary, not contradictory, is that Ar-Rahman describes the nature of Allah, and Ar-Rahim describes the actions of Allah. So Allah by His nature has rahmah, and all of His actions as well are actions of rahmah. And there are other interpretations as well about the differences between Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. And the name Ar-Rahim, it occurs a whopping 114 times in the Quran. It is one of the most oft repeated names of Allah after the name Allah. 114 times Allah mentions the name Ar-Rahim, and they occur with many names and combinations, but the two most common combinations of Ar-Rahim, and all of you have know these because they occur in the Quran, are Al-Ghafur Ar-Rahim and Al-Aziz Ar-Rahim. These combinations, Ghafur Rahim and Aziz Rahim, are of the most common combinations, period. Out of all of the combinations in the Quran, remember I said 3 days ago that most of Allah's names occur in pairs. The two most common pairs in the whole Quran are Al-Ghafur Ar-Rahim and Al-Aziz Ar-Rahim. And as I mentioned 3 days ago or 2 days ago, that when those two names occur together, there's always a wisdom. Why did Allah pair those two names? So the name Al-Aziz Ar-Rahim, and we're going to come to the name Aziz in a few days, and for now we'll just say Al-Aziz is the one of power. So Allah says Al-Aziz Ar-Rahim, the one who has power, the one who has mercy. What is the third meaning that we derive? Allah Azza wa Jal is saying, when He says He has Az-Izzah and He has Rahmah, that His Rahmah is not coming from weakness. His Rahmah is not coming because He has no other choice. Because usually, or sometimes, you are merciful out of weakness. You are merciful because you don't have power. Typically, people of power have no mercy. Typically, power corrupts mankind. Typically, the higher up you go, the harder your heart becomes. And this is the sunnah of Allah in the entire creation from the beginning of times. إِنَّ الْمُلُوكَ إِذَا دَخَلُوا قَرْيَةً أَفْسَدُوهَا وَجَعَلُوا أَعِزَّةَ أَهْلِهَا أَذِلَّةَ Kings and politicians, Allah is mentioned in the Quran, they typically corrupt, they cause evil, they don't have rahmah in their hearts. But Allah is saying, I have the ultimate power and my power has not corrupted me so that I'm no longer merciful. And my mercy does not come from weakness, it comes from strength. So Allah has both strength and He has mercy. He has the perfection of Izzah and He has the perfection of Rahmah. And that is why Al-Aziz al-Rahim is one of the most common combinations. And our Qari today also mentioned this combination. And of course, of the most common combinations, and we hear this all the time, is Al-Ghafoor al-Rahim. And we understand clearly why. Al-Ghafoor, we will come to the name Al-Ghafoor in detail next week, inshallah. But for now, we all know Al-Ghafoor means the one who forgives. So Allah is the one who forgives because He has mercy. Allah forgives because He has Rahmah. So because He is merciful, that mercy leads Him to forgive. And this is the wisdom of combining between Al-Ghafoor and Al-Rahim. Now, we mentioned there are five names, Rahman, Rahim, Arhamur Rahimin, Khairur Rahimin, and Dhur Rahmah. What should be the effects of these names on our heart? What is the thamara, or the fruits, of believing in these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Well, number one, these names should cause us to increase in our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the heart always loves the one who is kind and merciful to it. The heart always loves the one who is kind and merciful to it. The one who loves you, you automatically love him back. The one who is kind to you, automatically feel a love for this being. So how about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has given you everything? Everything that you love, Allah has given it to you. Everything that you find comfort in, Allah has given it to you. So how much more should be your love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demonstrated that love in a beautiful hadith when he was in a battle and a lady was separated from her child and she was frantically searching for the child and she finally screamed joy when she found the child alive and she picked up the child and she began feeding the child. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remarked, do you think this lady would ever throw her child into a fire? And they said, Subhanallah, O Messenger of Allah, how could this mother ever do this to his child? So the Prophet ﷺ said, Lallahu arhamu min hadhihi min ibniha. Lallahu, indeed, it's a swear, a qasam. I swear, Allah is arham, more rahmah. Allah has more rahmah for His creation and for His believers than this lady has for her child. So when we understand this, then our love for Allah Azza wa Jal should skyrocket. Number two, when we know Allah is Rahman, and Allah is Rahim, and Allah is Arhamur Rahimin, our hope in Allah and in His mercy should go to infinite lengths. We have to have hope in Allah, that Allah shall show us Rahmah. We have to have good thoughts about Allah. You see, brothers and sisters, some Muslims, unfortunately, they have an incorrect understanding of Allah, astaghfirullah, as an angry or a nasty God. La hawla quwwata illa billah. This is not the Allah of the Quran. Our Prophet has told us that the Prophet ﷺ said that Allah has said, Ana inda dhanni abdi bi. I shall deal with my servants the way they assume I shall deal with them. So the one who thinks Allah is going to be generous and kind, the one who has positive thoughts about Allah, Allah will deal with him in that positive manner. Allah will deal with him in that positive manner. And this is proven in the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of the rich man, the Prophet ﷺ told us a story that once upon a time there was a rich man from the previous generations. He would lend his money to people. And then he would send his slave to collect the debts of the people. And he would say to the person, you know, if you find he doesn't have the money, then show him mercy. Maybe Allah will be merciful if I'm merciful to other people. So when he died, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him that I have more right to show mercy to you than you had the right to show mercy to those people. And he was forgiven because of that. This is the concept of rahmah, that the man said, Allah will show mercy to me, inshallah Allah will show mercy to me. And he was merciful to the people, wanting Allah's mercy. So Allah Azza wa Jal gave him that mercy. And of course the famous hadith of the prostitute who saw the dog thirsty on the sand, not able to drink, and feeling pity and rahmah for the dog. She had rahmah for the dog. She went into the well and she put some water in her shoe. And she put the shoe in her mouth because she had to climb up. And then she fed the dog. And the Prophet ﷺ said, because of her rahmah, she's a prostitute. Because of her rahmah for the dog. And the dog is not a noble animal in our Sharia. Allah had rahmah on her. This is Allah who is Rahim and Rahman. When she showed rahmah to Allah's creation, Allah showed rahmah to her. So when we understand how much is Allah's rahmah, and I quoted yesterday the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that even the kafir, if he knew how much rahmah Allah had, he would hope he's going to enter Jannah. And the famous scholar of hadith, Sufyan al-Thawri, when he was on his deathbed, he said to the people, Wallahi, I am more happier that Allah will judge me on the Day of Judgment than even my own mother, because I trust the mercy of Allah more than I trust my own mother's mercy. This is the love that these great scholars of the past had. That the yaqeen that Allah is Rahman and Rahim. Allah is Dhur Rahmah. Allah is full of Rahmah. So he said, I would rather Allah judge me than my own mother and father, because Allah will be more merciful to me than my own mother and father. Of the benefits of believing in Allah's names, Rahman and Rahim, number three, is to be shy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What does this mean to be shy? You know, when somebody is generous to you, then how can you insult him back? When somebody gives you so much, then you feel that I must repay this person back. This feeling is a positive feeling. So how about Allah Azza wa Jal, who has given us everything? Should we not feel a sense of shyness? That how can I use Allah's blessings against him? How can I use Allah's wealth that he has given me in sins against him? How can I use Allah's everything to come between me and Allah? There should be an element of haya. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentions in the Quran, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you would try to count the blessings of Allah, sit down and count them. Think about how many blessings Allah has given you. You will not even be able to finish the list. This is what the Quran is telling us. So we should feel a sense of haya from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As well, of the benefits of believing in the name of Allah, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, is that we should be merciful unto other people. We should have rahmah for other people. As our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam demonstrated, when a man came and said, Ya Rasulullah, I have a hard heart. I don't have mercy. I find no emotions. What should I do? So the Prophet ﷺ said, go and wipe the hair of the orphans. How are you going to get merciful? Go and wipe the hair of the orphans means be with the poor, be with the wretched, be with the deprived. Have mercy, be with them. When a Bedouin came and he saw the Prophet ﷺ playing with Hassan and Hussein, he would throw him up in the air, kiss him. And you know, the Bedouins, they're known to be coarse and harsh. He said, you do this with your children? I have 10 sons, I've never once picked them up, never once kissed them. This is macho-ness, a false macho-ness. And the Prophet ﷺ said, what can I do if Allah has removed rahmah from your hearts? You have so little rahmah, you can't even play with your own children. So having rahmah upon other people. And our Prophet ﷺ said that of the signs of respecting Allah, of respecting Allah, is to show respect to our elders and to be merciful to our youngsters. There should be a feeling of compassion that we must feel, be moved. Once the Prophet ﷺ was giving a khutbah and some of the Bedouins came, and these were such poor people, they weren't Bedouins, excuse me, they're from another tribe that were coming to accept Islam. They were so poor, they literally only had something to cover their awrah and they had nothing else. And our Prophet ﷺ was so moved. He stood up after the khutbah and he had a fundraiser right then and there for them. And he said, who is going to help them with food and whatnot? And people began to bring until there was a pile to give to them. The heart of the Prophet is moved when he sees that poverty in front of him. This is what rahmah does. So of the benefits of believing in Allah's names, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim, that we try to have mercy onto other people. And of course, of the benefits of believing in these names of Allah is to use them in dua. And I'll continually mention this in every name that I mention. To use them in dua. We should use the name Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. We should use it whenever we have any dua. You see, most of Allah's names are specific to something you want. Ya Kareem, you use it for specific things. Ya Wahhab, Ya Shafi. But there are some names of Allah that are universal. You can use them for quite literally anything, such as the name Allah, such as the name Rabb, and such as the name Rahman and Rahim. There's no specific issue except that the name Rahman and Rahim is relevant to your dua. You want forgiveness, you want Jannah, you want a job, you want children, whatever you want. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. So you use the names of Allah, you're invoking the one who has rahmah. And especially when you're in trouble, especially when you're in trouble, when you're suffering a calamity, when your heart is hurting, when you're physically sick, when you're emotionally grieved, who better to solve your problem than the one who has rahmah? Ayyub, 10 years leprosy. He's lost his 10 children. His wealth, he was a multimillionaire, is down to poverty. He has nothing. Everybody leaves him. For 10 years, he's a pariah, outcast. And he raises his hands and what does he say? Ya Rab, inni massani al-dur wa anta arhamur rahimin. Oh my Lord, you see my pitiful situation. You see how what I'm in. I'm in pain. I'm suffering. And you, O Allah, are the arhamur rahimin. That's all. Ayyub did not even say, O Allah, get rid of the pain. He just said, you are arhamur rahimin. You see my situation. That's all I need to do. So Allah says, فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ ضُرٍ. When he made this dua, so please memorize it. Let's use it. رَبِّ إِنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرِ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. This is the dua of Ayyub. رَبِّ إِنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرِ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. When he made the dua, Allah says, we lifted up all the problems that he had and we gave him more than we took away. So this is of the benefits of believing in the names of Allah, Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. The final points, how do we attain the rahmah of Allah? How do we attain the rahmah of Allah? Well, number one, I already mentioned it. Give rahmah to others, Allah will give rahmah to you. And this is in the beautiful hadith, memorize it, beautiful Arabic. Ar-Rahimun يرحمهم الرحمن ارحموا من في الأرض يرحمكم من في السماء الرحمون, the ones who have mercy, يرحمهم الرحمن, الرحمن will have mercy on them. The ones who show mercy will be shown mercy by the one who has mercy. Have mercy on the people in the world, the one in the heavens will have mercy on you. This is a hadith, beautiful hadith. You want Allah's rahmah, be merciful even to dogs. Be merciful to animals. Be merciful to plants. Be merciful to the creation. And Allah will be merciful to you. You want Allah's rahmah? Our Prophet ﷺ said, Rahim Allahu abdan. May Allah will have mercy on the person. When he buys, he's gentle. When he sells, he's gentle. When he interacts with others, he's gentle. Gentleness and mercy with other people, Rahim Allah, Allah's mercy will be on you. So number one way to get Allah's mercy is to be merciful. Number two, coming to the masjid, praying, listening to Islamic knowledge. Hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. The ones who never does a group come to the house of Allah and recite the Quran and listen to gatherings of knowledge, except that rahmah comes and envelopes them. Rahmah comes and envelopes them. And sakina descends upon them and the angels envelope them in their wings. So rahmah will come to the people who come to the masajid. So coming to the masajid brings about Allah's rahmah. And number three, and this is the final point we'll mention, of the ways to bring about Allah's mercy is to obey Allah and His Messenger. وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Obey Allah and His Messenger so that you may attain Allah's mercy. Remember, brothers and sisters, Allah says in the Quran that إِنَّ عَذَابِ أُصِيبُ بِهِ مَنْ أَشَاءُ. My punishment, it shall only reach the people that I want. My punishment will only go to the people I choose. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My rahmah encompasses everything. This is Allah, our Lord. This is Ar-Rahman. This is Ar-Rahim. This is Arhamur Rahimeen. This is Khairur Rahimeen. This is the Rahmah. If this is our Lord, then how can we possibly despair of the mercy of the one who is the ultimate in compassion and mercy. May Allah Azza wa Jal increase our love and iman in Ar-Rahman. May Allah bless us to be merciful to His creation so that we may attain His mercy. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us amongst the servants of Ar-Rahman. And we'll continue other names tomorrow, inshaAllah ta'ala. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
تعدد حبات الرمال وأكثرا صلى عليك الله ما غيث هما فوق السهول وبالجبال وبالقرى فوق السهول وبالجبال وبالقرى.